I was going to say, the next congressman of the 5th District, would you welcome James and Cindy and their family, Lankford? But
wow. Yeah. Yeah. Well, let me just say, I just received about 15 minutes ago a really gracious, kind call from Kevin Calvey. He had spoken to his supporters. And he'd said, I'm going to give James my full support. He called me to say, I'm going to give you my full support. And he was just very, very gracious. People have told us through this whole campaign that it's unique. And the reason it's unique is because of this group of folks that's right here. And folks that are all over the district that invested their time and their life and their finances and their trust. And they've invested into what they believe needs to happen in our nation. And I want to say to you, thank you for the way that you've trusted us and our family, but also for your passion for where you see this nation is supposed to go. So for all of you, thank you. I know very well that we just finished the second round of a three-round fight, but let me just say again how incredibly blessed of a man that I am to stand with Cindy, Hannah, and Jordan, who have sacrificed unbelievably in this journey. The co-chairs that were up here earlier and several others that couldn't be here, the donors that have donated so faithfully, the folks that have volunteered their time and their life, and that I've asked you to do again, by the way. I just want to say thank you to that group. This campaign has always been about a sense of calling and ideas. Volunteers from all three counties that are just normal Oklahomans that have a passion for our God, have a passion for our families, have a passion for our country, have come together as a bunch of rookies that we are. We just seem to have this same common belief that we just want our children to have the same America that we grew up with. As a community, we're convinced that this current set of leaders in Washington, D.C., in the House of Representatives, is spending too much, is taxing too much, and cares about the next generation too little. In short, this one thing I believe to be true. The United States House of Representatives no longer represents us and our values, and that has to change. Has to. Let me just see if I can share some of our core principles. We believe this core principle. You cannot spend more than you have. I mean, it's a basic principle that all of us have to live by, that we also believe our federal government should as well. Hannah and I have had multiple conversations at different times where she would say to me, Dad, actually she says daddy because boys have a dad, girls have a daddy. That's the way it goes. So she would say, Daddy, where does all that money come from? And I've said to her every time, from you. That's right. Our nation has always sacrificed for the next generation. It's been a premise of who we are as a people until now. This group of leaders in the House of Representatives has made the deliberate decision to say, times are tough. I will make it tougher on my kids and my grandkids, so it won't be tough on me. And that is flat out wrong. We have lost our way as a nation. In so many arenas, we've lost our way. And I'm committed to you to say, if you'll send me in November, I will deliver this message to the House of Representatives. We are the United States of America, and the House of Representatives will represent us. I've noticed this. We used to be a nation that would get up in the morning and we'd cook breakfast for our children. Now we have become a nation that gets up in the morning, turns on the TV to see what Washington, D.C. did to us overnight while we were sleeping. You know what I mean? I'd like to just get up in the morning again and just cook breakfast for my kids. And I'd like to be able to say to the leadership in Washington, D.C., don't fix our problems. Fix your problems and do your job. We will fix our problems and do our job here in Oklahoma and allow them to be able to take on the things that they're supposed to do. Let us do the things that we're supposed to do. For the sake of the next generation, which is what we should be all about, I really believe we've got to get back to the basic principles of saying, in government, and specifically in the House of Representatives, we should go back to allowing businesses to succeed or fail on their own. That we should go back to a basic principle that you get to keep what you earn. That we have this basic principle that we're going to innovate in business, we're going to have the freedom to speak, the freedom to bear arms, and the freedom to worship as we choose. It's a basic principle of who we are as Americans. I really believe that is not a Democrat issue, and that's not a Republican issue. That's an American issue. And if you elect me in November, I plan to deliver that. It was the dream. It was the dream of our founders, you know, and you can read it in their original documents, that they dreamed of instituting a constitution and a republic that would stand out as a light to the nations around us. And they would stare at our freedom, and they'd be fascinated with it and drawn to it. George Washington, even in his farewell address, talked about how the other nations would applaud at our Constitution one day. And now we have become the most powerful economy on the planet. We have the most moral, most capable, best trained, best equipped fighting for liberty, and we should not give that away for the sake of a small group of leaders in Washington, D.C. that want to reinvent us for the location where they go take vacations. We need to be Americans and to say we are Americans, and what we have become has not been because of our socialism. It's become because of our freedom. And let's go back to that basic thing again. Let me just say, I really believe elections are the gift to our republic. Other nations around the world have dictatorships, and the way they transition in leadership is so different than how we do it. We have this peaceful transition of leadership that astounds many parts of the world. I'm so glad we keep that. Believe me now, for me stepping from the private sector into the public world, I understand full well the blood, sweat, and tears, as many of you do, of what it takes to do an election. Look around this room for a moment. Many of the people in this room have given up countless hours. You've walked around neighborhoods in the heat of July and August. You've picked up the phone and called total strangers that you would have never done a year ago. But because of this passion that you have worked incredibly hard. Early in this journey, there were 7 Republicans and their volunteers, and they were working just as hard as you. Honor them when you bump into them. You'll meet them around town at different points. Give them great respect, because they also worked very hard and thought this day would be different for them. So we stand with them on that. But I also say, as Republicans, we should stand together. Because on November the 2nd, we want a Republican to go back to the House of Representatives. Our desire is on November 2nd, all around the country, there's a groundswell of conservatism that goes back to the basic principles of freedom and who we've always been, and that we would win the House of Representatives back and send Nancy Pelosi back to San Francisco. And I can tell you, when we send Nancy Pelosi back to San Francisco, I really am looking forward to her flying coach. Yeah. Oklahoma has tremendous resources. Our water, our land, our oil and natural gas, our industry. But our best export, I really believe, is our people and our ideas. I wish that Washington, D.C. would become more like Oklahoma than that Oklahoma would become more like Washington, D.C. So here is my humble request to you. In 10 weeks, there is another election. And I would be very honored to have your help in saying, let's take Oklahoma and who we are in this room to Washington, D.C., and say, howdy. We're going to do things different. For all of you from us, please hear this. I understand my name is on the sign, which still freaks me out every time I see it. You cannot imagine driving down the street and seeing your name out on the side of the road. It's very odd. I understand my name isn't the sign. That's the way it has to be. But you need to hear from our family. We talk often of this campaign as us and we, because I firmly believe it is. And when folks have come to us and say, how did you do that? I laugh. And I say, I didn't do that. We've worked hard. But it's been with God's blessing, and it's been the passion of tons of people that have volunteered their time and money, that what no one could have imagined is occurring. And it is our dream to continue to have that, and to be able to say, we're going to Washington, and we're going to honor this value. And when I'm home on weekends in between stuff, I expect you to look me in the face at the mall and say, I'm holding you accountable to where you were at the beginning. Do not become D.C. And I will smile at you and say, I'm going to stay Oklahoma. Thank you again. I mean it. And I want to pray for us, and then I think somebody else is coming up. Am I right or wrong on that? I'm looking for my cue here. That's a yes, that's a no. That's a no. Okay. Let me make two requests of you, and then I want to pray for you. And it's going to sound like the same stuff I've been saying for a year. I'd love to have your help as a volunteer. And if you've got an extra dollar, The Democrats have been raising money while the Republicans have been running a runoff. And we'd love to have some help because we need to get ready for November now. So if you want to help in any way, you can check in with these nice folks over here at this table back here, or you can go online. You know that. I think you've heard us say jameslankford.com a few times before. Be able to check in with us because we would love to be able to have your help. Let me pray for us. Father, thank you for the gift of our friendship and the families that are here. and the way that you have taken care of us and have guided us. Father, I never have to think if we love this country and this people more than you do. We know you love us. Each person in this room and outside of this room, across our state, nation, and world, you have a unique affection for. And you do have a plan for our nation. And we pray that we would be wise and that we would live lives of integrity and that we would honor you with our families and set the tone for the nation. There is such a great need for people just to live lives of integrity and honor their families and their neighbors. God, help us to do that. I pray for peace for our nation. As there are other primaries going on, I pray for unity among our party, that we wouldn't be contentious. And I pray for this November, that you would cause a stirring across our nation, that have uniquely have your thumbprint, that you would redirect us as a country to living as a government responsibly and to honoring you and our families. God, help us in that. Help us in it. Bless these volunteers that have given so much of their time and life and treasure. I pray that they would leave tonight with joy and a sense of accomplishment for what they have done and where they've been a part of. Use it, please. Bless them and their families. In the name of Jesus, I ask. Amen. God bless you. Thank you.